Before we get into this video today, guys, I did not mention in the video, I want you guys to drop a comment on this video today telling me your favorite investment going into FIFA 19. Who is the guy that you guys just need to get all over next year as an investment and really need to pick up? I'm interested to hear. I've been reading the comments a lot in the last video about you guys, how much money you're spending. It's been really interactive and I'm really enjoying it. Let me know in the comments down below who is the guy you guys are rocking with as the best investment in your head going into FIFA 19. Enjoy the video, guys. Yo, dudes, what is going on? It is your boy Nick from Run the Foot Market. It's going to be simple. It's going to be fun. It's going to be quick. It's going to be exciting today. We have a great video for you guys. I hope you guys are all ready for it and ready to go for FIFA 19. I'm there, right? So hopefully we keep this hype train going. If you guys enjoy the video today, drop a thumbs up. If you don't, you don't. But we got some good stuff today. And on the screen, you guys see a ones to watch team, but that's not what we're talking about today. It's going to be a little bit of a part of it. Today, I want to give you guys my top five groundbreaking potential investments. And I know there's a lot of words going on there. You may not know what the hell any of that means, right? I want to highlight that word potential. Right, every single year there is a player or two players, you know, and I'm thinking that's why I want to do a top five, because there's five players on the borderline this year for me of being insane investments. So what it means is that they're either going to be very bang average, not really go up a ton of investments, kind of go up with everything when the game comes out. If you guys don't know, when the full game release comes out, the whole market goes up, right? Because you have a lot of users coming on, people opening packs, and it rises until the first week in league. So those guys will fit into that average category. Then you have banging investments. You have guys that were very close or not certain to having certain things happen to make them go up, and it happens and boom, you got in early and they go flying. So that's kind of what we're talking about today. And it's going to be five players that for me are on the borderline of getting into ones to watch, but are not certain to be getting in. And there's a big, big importance on that, right? And it's something that I want you guys to take a risk on if you're looking into making a lot of money on a game-breaking investment early on. If you're trying to hit the bank big, this might be the good video for you guys to watch. I'm excited to bring it to you guys. And just before we go any further into this video, I want to show you what I'm talking about as a little bit of proof for all of you guys watching the video. Nelson Semedo got into a once to watch team last year. If you are not familiar with the concept of what we've been talking about on the channel recently, every once to watch card that gets into the 23-man roster, their gold card goes out of packs for a week. Now, their gold card goes out of packs very early on in FIFA 19. It goes out of packs literally, like, after being on the market for what? 2 days of the full game release and like 5 days of the pregame release. So the pregame release, no one's really opening packs. Full game release, you've got 2 days of them getting packed and that's it, right? After that, they go out of packs. Ship has sailed. If you want to use this card, you got to buy the ones to watch at an expensive price or you got to buy the gold at a cheaper but inflated price. So Nelson Semedo was one of my game-breaking investments last year. One of my game, you know, big time. If you were able to get in with him, he was going to make you a lot of coins. Now, here was the reason. Nelson Semedo, for me, I knew that he was going to have a lot of pace and he was going to be playing for Barcelona. I knew that regardless of him getting a once to watch, he transferred and he was going to be big time in that league. I know pace is huge early on in FIFA. So, essentially, he was not certain to get in ones to watch last year. If you guys take a look at ones to watch, you'll see you have Kyle Walker, you have Serge Aurier. You had so many potential right backs getting into that ones to watch team that it wasn't certain that Semedo was going to get in. He was like a third / fourth option. So I said, you know what? I think he's getting in. I looked at the Barcelona players and I said, you know what? He's going to Barcelona. He's going to get in. That for me is going to happen, right? So you guys can see here, and this is what I want to show you. This doesn't mean you need to buy this during early access. You can still buy this in the first 2 days of FIFA because nobody's going to know the ones to watch till the Friday of that promo week, right? Semedo is between, what, we're going to say early access. I think I bought him during like a 3,000 to 4,000 coin period. I just held till he went all the way up. This is still the day or two before, you know, this promo drops. Look at what happens 2 days into the promo dropping. He's out of packs for two damn days. Nelson Semedo, he's 11K. You bought at 3K, that is game-changing, game-breaking. You're making 9,000 coins a card. Right, so that's something you guys got to look at as like, this is potentially in this video and what I'm going to be showing you guys today with potential cards that I think are on the border, if not being game-changing investments for you guys to buy their gold cards of in that 9-day period before Once the Watch drops. So let's get right into the video. Nelson Semedo was just the example that I wanted to show you guys before we get rolling with the top five that I have for you guys. So guys, I wanted to go with players here that are realistic. I wanted to go with players that I think have a really good shot at getting into Once the Watch but are still on the border. I don't have Kepa 100% into Once the Watch. Although he was like the most expensive goalkeeper transfer ever, I still think with Courtois going to Madrid, you know, last year's ones to watch, I believe, only had Ederson as a keeper, so they only did one keeper. And then you also have Buffon going to PSG, Leno going to Arsenal. You have so many transfers going on with the goalkeepers that this one is not a certainty one for me. I don't think it is. You also can argue right here, and the counter argument could be, you know, he's going to Chelsea. Chelsea has to get a ones to watch. The Premier League. Guys, Jorginho's gone to Chelsea. Kovacic has gone to Chelsea. We've got two other big-time players who have just transferred to Chelsea. So those guys are in the running for ones to watch. We've never even seen more than two players from the same team get a ones to watch, I believe, in the same content promo release. Kepa's a very interesting one for me. I think everyone's looking for that meta goalkeeper next year in the Premier League. He could offer it all. He could be really, really OP in FIFA next year. 83 rated is probably what he will be. We will get player ratings officially tomorrow for the guys that are excited for that. And we're going to get a ton of content out with that. But this is, again, another prep video for I want you guys to start thinking and using this information to really get yourself prepared. And I think a lot of these things haven't been talked about. I think Kepa, if he does get a once to watch, this is going to be a groundbreaking investment. I can't even explain to you guys. If you check out Ederson's graph, his gold card on this year's FIFA of what happened when his once to watch went into packs, I believe he went from like 7 to 21K. Something like that. Something crazy. So we're looking at an investment that if you pick this up and you take the risk, first of all, I think he's going to rise anyways as the game comes out. But if he hits in a ones to watch, you're making bank. You're going to make a lot of coins if this guy gets in a ones to watch. And so that's why I've got him in at this top five. Just so you guys know, I don't really have this top five in any kind of order. These guys are all equally very, very looking and good and promising for investment value this year in FIFA. All right, guys. Next up, we have the guy Fabinho. This is a weird one for me. You know, you've got Shaqiri going to Liverpool. You've got Naby Keita going to Liverpool. You've got Alisson going to Liverpool. Now Fabinho. There are so many signings with Liverpool that will they be the team that breaks the record of more than two players getting in on a ones to watch squad? Will they get three? I don't know. That's why this one's weird for me. I feel like Keita's a lock. Not sure about Alisson. So I have it between Alisson and Fabinho for the second. I don't know. Look, I'll tell you this. If he does get a ones to watch, this gold card is going to fly. And you guys I can promise you that. If he gets a ones to watch, this is groundbreaking. This is a card that will make you a lot of coins, right? If you buy this card before the full game release, if you buy it before the Once the Watch comes out, this card will make you the big bucks. If you guys want the big bucks and that's something you're interested in, this is your guy. Brazilian, CDM, a position that's kind of lacking for cheap players and overpowered players in this league. You know, you've got N'Golo Kante, you can use Herrera. Not really a tall guy, you have Matic, but he's a little slower. You know, this guy is somebody that's going to really offer a lot of starter teams a really good player. So I think that this guy is a guy you guys got to look at as like a dude you got to be maybe fucking with and rocking with as an investment. Now guys, this could be one of my favorite investments of them all, and it's not because he was like my favorite player this FIFA or something. It is literally because this is an insane transfer for the FIFA junkies, for the guys that know the overpowered players. This is a guy that is just, this is such a good transfer for any guy who likes the market, anyone who likes the gameplay. You've got a left wing / left forward / left mid now in the La Liga that is going to be overpowered. Hopefully, fingers crossed, getting special cards this year. And it's just that guy, Quincy Promes, man. He is so freaking good in FIFA. And this year I had over like 600 total games with his SBC card. He's now going to be playing a La Liga. He's officially with Sevilla. This is what I'm saying. So you would think that he's going to get a once to watch, right? Because that's a big transfer. But because it's been so recent, it happened within the last week and FIFA 19 is so close. It's not confirmed that he's going to get a once to watch. It's not 100% certain. I don't know if it is. I think it's a big transfer. I think it's a La Liga thing, and we don't have a ton of La Liga transfers this year. I think he's going to get in. I think that. But I think the whole world, and I've looked at predictions, guys. He is not in all these predictions. Like, whatever predictions I've been looking at, he has not been in the majority of the predictions. So Quincy Promes really turns me on as an investment. I think that is a guy you guys got to look at as a card that if he does get a once to watch, this is going to fly. It's a very overpowered card. It's a card that is going to be very desirable for a lot of people early on in FIFA. They're going to look at that card on the market and say, okay, four star. I believe he's four star. I had to try this guy out, right? I think people are going to look at it and say, wow. You know, it might be three star, four star, but he's got a four star weak foot, and that's a very big stat for early on FIFA guys. So he's another guy that I got to say, out of these five, is probably my favorite. I know it's outside of the Premier League, but he does look really good next year to make some kind of coins with. Guys, I've said it time and time again. Ricardo Pereira is very similar to Nelson Semedo this year, right? If Ricardo Pereira finds himself in this once to watch team, just like Nelson Semedo snuck on in there last year, you're going to hit the money. You're going to hit the jackpot on making coins. And this is something that, look, with all these cards we're talking about today, there is minimum risk because the market goes up anyways. But these are not guaranteed guys that are getting into ones to watch. But what they will guarantee you is that if they do get into ones to watch, you're going to make a lot more coins on these guys than any of the other guys' as gold cards going out of packs, because those guys were more confirmed, per se, like N'Golan. Those guys are going to already be expected to get into ones to watch, right? This is a guy that, for me, It's a BPL right back, EPL right back, whatever you call the league. This is big time for me. I really think that this guy, I tell you guys every year, I always have a few picks of guys that I think, regardless of them being OP, just have hype around them, are in a good position, I have a good nationality, and are in a good league. Nelson Semedo was one of them last year. I also liked Morata a lot last year. Both of those guys went flying. Ricardo Pereira is going to be one of mine this year. I think that that's a pretty big time move from Liga NOS. I believe he was with Porto before. So I think for me, guys, this is something you guys got to look at seriously as buying. Ricardo Pereira is no joke as an investment this year. And I think you have to look at him as a guy that is only going to go upwards, similar to Pereira, to Semedo, probably from that 5 to 20,000, 17.5 range if he gets in. You're looking at triple profits plus if he gets into this Once the Watch team. All right, guys, last up, we're going back to the La Liga, man. We got Malcolm in this video. Now, I think Malcolm might be an 83 rated, so this is being very low on the ratings. I don't want to like go high on the ratings and piss people off because I know that's a thing on YouTube, and I don't want to do that. But, look, guys, this is something we got to talk about, right? Brazilian, Barcelona, I don't think he has 5-star skills, but I think he has 4-star, which is significant as hell. That's a great combination to have with any kind of midfielder, any kind of winger. That is a lethal thing to have with a player that is on your team. So, I think he's got a lot of hype to his name as well. I think you think of Malcolm, and it's more than Malcolm, right? It's a player that is a guy who's young and similar to Mbappe. Not that he's the same player, don't go wrong with that, but in terms of a younger guy who just seems like he's got some kind of flair to his game, right? He's got some kind of skilling, he's got some excitement about him, and I think that's always really good for Once the Watch cards as investments. So, especially not even Once the Watch cards, just cards early on in the game, it's always good for. It's always good for cards that are not the most looked at, and you know, they gather a lot of hype as time goes. So, I'm looking at Malcolm, guys, to wrap up this top five today as to be a definite player that is going to go up if he does get a Once the Watch. I think Malcolm, out of all these players today, is probably the biggest lock out of Once the Watch, but I think his gold card is going to fly out of packs. If you're not familiar with the concept, guys, these gold cards, again, go up when their Once the Watch goes in packs early on. You buy them before the full game release. Hope you guys enjoyed the video today. If you guys are enjoying the content, drop a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments down below, who is your favorite investment going into FIFA 19? Somebody you think is going to go flying up in value. Who is your favorite investment? Let me know in the comments down below now.